Hi everyone, welcome to Python learning series for network engineers. This is the second video on how to do Fortigate CLI automation using Python. In the first video, we have seen how to execute a basic show command, get the output in terminal, and send set of commands to configure an IP address object. We will verify that the object what we created. So this is the object what we created using Python script. You can see the command here. In this video, we'll see how to send set of commands by reading a CSV file. So we have a CSV file here, 01 IP list. This contains object name and IP address. So the object name is going to be user 1 and IP address is going to be the respective IPs for each user. So let us see how to do that. So for that, I'll go to PyCharm and I'll create a Python file here, 02 CLI from CSV. And first we will write a logic for reading this CSV file. Here you can see the header for this is name and IP, and below headers we have the below name we have individual names and then we have IPs. So we will use CSV dictionary reader for this. So first I'll import that from CSV import dict reader, and we will first write logic for reading the CSV file and creating a dictionary. Then we will copy and paste the SSH logic and we'll frame this configuration based on this CSV file. So first I need to open the file, so I'll use with open method, and then the file name is 01 underscore IP list, and I'll call this as CSV file. Then I'll call this variable IP details equals then the above imported method, the dict reader method, and CSV file. I'll use this, and let us see what is IP details. We'll try running it. So you can see here it is a dict reader object. Now I'll just comment this. This is actually an iteratable object. So what we'll do, for IP in IP details, then we'll do a print of IP now, because this was a dict reader object and now we are doing a for loop within that. Now let us just try printing IP. So here you can see now I am getting this as a dictionary. So the key is the header name and value is the respective values. You can see name and IP. So I got 5 dictionaries here based on this CSV. Now if we need only the name of the users, what I can do is I can just do print name, and you can see it is printing the name. Similar to that, even if I need IP, I can just give the header name. You can see here now I am able to read the CSV file. Now within this for loop, now we need to apply our configuration. So what I'll do, just copy this. Paste it here and I'll just give a description. Configuring object, and then I'll give object as IPs name. Now each iteration it will just print the name, so it will say the user 1, user 2, user 3. Now let's frame the configuration. So what we can do, config equals, let me just copy paste this configuration. And here we need to pass the variables. So here one place where we need to pass variable is here, which is going to be our name. So I'll just format this using fstring, and here I'll pass the variable, the same name. You can just copy this and paste it here. And since it is in single quotes, I need to give name within double quotes, that should be careful. Yeah, and similar to that, here also we need to pass the variable. So let me just change that as well. So here this should be formatted string, and this is going to be IP. Now let us just try doing a print of config in each iteration. There is a syntax error. Yeah. You can see here it is framing configuration for each user. So config firewall address, edit user 1, IP address 101, 102. So it is framing configuration for each user. Now we'll change this config. And here we'll change the subnet as well, so that in the next video we'll be adding this into different groups. That time what we'll do, we'll add these three into one group and these two into another group. So let me just save this file. We'll try running this script again. Yeah. So you can see here this is updated the configuration. Now to push this configuration, we need to introduce our previous SSH logic here, so the Netmiko logic. So I'll just copy paste that script. So first I'll copy from Netmiko. Then the firewall connection, I'll put it here. Then after connection, we need to send config within this loop, for loop. So what we can do here, I'll copy this logic put it within this. So now in each iteration it is going to send the configuration to the device, each iteration of this IP. So and finally we'll do a print. Print of send config. Now let us try running this script. Now it is trying to connect to the device, so we'll verify even the objects here. So now we don't have the objects. Now this will be trying to connect to the device. Script will be here. Yeah. So you can see here it has added. So configuring object user 01, and it is creating user 01, then user 2 with IP 102, and 3 with 103, then 4 with 1.104 and 105. So we'll verify here. Yeah, you can see it has created all these 5 objects from the CSV file. If you want, you can add a delay here so that in terminal you will be able to read it. Like under for loop, time dot sleep, and you can give a 2 seconds delay so that you will be able to read each execution. Yeah. In the next video, we'll see how to assign this to a group from the script itself. So you can see here we have 2 groups. First 3 IPs we will assign to one group, and 4 and 5 we will assign to another group. I hope this video was helpful. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.